Welcome to the Titanium Life Podcast. This is your host, Armand Sadeghi, and today we're going to talk about your business. Now, whether you already have a business and you're trying to take it to the next level, or you're an entrepreneur who has just started a business, or you're an entrepreneur who is currently working for someone else and wants to get into a business, this is the most important thing you need to understand in order to take your next step. You see, I coach a lot of business people. And it's amazing to me that whether they've been doing business for a year, for 5 years, or for 10 years or more, when I walk in, the first question I ask them is I say, tell me specifically what business you're in. And I say, exactly who is your ideal client? And what I'm shocked by is 90% of the people I talk to and I coach have no clue what business they're in and have no clue what their ideal client is or who their ideal client is. Now, listen. They give me some answer. It's not like they say, well, I don't know. They give me some answer, but it's clear it's not something they thought through. So I ask you this question. What business are you in exactly? And who is your ideal client? Now, let's say you're a dentist and you hear this, right? A dentist is someone we can all relate to because we've all been to the dentist, right? So I say, what business are you? They say, well, I'm in the dentistry business. I'm in the business of dentistry. And who's your ideal client? Well, you know, anybody who needs work done on their teeth. See, that's not the answer I'm looking for. I'm looking for them to tell me exactly what business they are in and exactly who their ideal client is. Because see, not every dentist is in the same business, right? Some dentists are focused, for example, on being the kind of dentist that creates a calm and soothing environment so people can feel at peace when they're there. So then their ideal client is someone who wants their experience at the dentist to be calm and relaxing, right? Something along those lines where someone else is going to say, I have the highest quality dentistry practice you can possibly imagine, right? That's a totally different concept. Now, not that the person who creates relaxing and soothing environment isn't going to go for the highest quality, but see, that is not their business. Some other people are focused on a certain region, right? Some people go after a certain type of group of people. So for example, some dentists might be the type of dentist who go after children, for example, right? And their ideal client becomes a kid between a certain age and a certain age. But at the same time, in that case even, the client isn't the kid, the client is the parent. So they need to understand that. So today, what I want to talk to you about is I want to make sure you understand exactly what business you're in and who your ideal client is. And then we're going to talk about this concept that I talk about it because I don't want you to get blockbustered. All right? So write that down. Don't get blockbustered. That's an important thing. And today, I'm going to talk to you about how to not end up having the same fate that Blockbuster Video had. And we'll talk about what happened to cause Blockbuster Video, this massive company that really controlled and ruled the market, what caused them to crash and burn, and crash and burn so quickly, right? And in such an ugly manner, and have this incredible company fall apart. Why? Because they made one simple error. And I'm going to tell you what that error is, and I'm going to make sure you don't make the same error in your business. But let's start with first things first. What business are you in? Now, when I say what business you're in, what that means is I want you to identify exactly what business you're in, what products and services are the key products and services that you want to give people, the solutions you're going to provide people or businesses, right? You can be a B2B or B2C. That means business to business or business to consumer. But you want to make sure that you know exactly what you're doing for your business. In order to identify that, you're really going to have to break your business down. And you're going to have to stop trying to be everything to everybody. So if at the end of the day, you were really going to be one thing, what would that thing be? And what would you call that business? And how would you describe that business? That's what I want you to do. And today, you absolutely must take the time to identify exactly what business you're in. And for me, for example, I've got 6 different companies. And each of them is in a different industry. But it's important for me to know with each of those companies, exactly what business I'm in. And for many of you entrepreneurs out there, you're sort of all over the place, right? And you're trying to do everything, and that's okay. There's nothing wrong with trying to do multiple things. Although, as I've said repeatedly, focus is what creates incredible power in life. So you must learn to have focus. But that doesn't mean you just work on one thing. It just means whatever you're in, be focused on it 100%. But at the same time, you've got to decide what is your primary business. What is the business that's going to make you thrive? And what exactly is that business? All right. So for example, if I'm doing this podcast, right, I've got to identify what is this podcast going to be all about? And I have to decide, is it about motivating people? Is it about giving out information? What is it about? And for me, it's all about helping entrepreneurs and business people take their businesses to a completely different level. And the way I help them do that is by making sure that I help them thrive in their personal and in their business lives. See, that's what sets me apart. So if you're going to compare this podcast to the next podcast that talks about business, the difference is I'm focused on you as a business owner, as opposed to someone else who might be focused on marketing and sales. My focus is, how do I get you to thrive? And that means I can't only give you the business tools, I must give you the personal tools as well. But see, do you see after listening to that, you think to yourself, wow, yeah, this Armand guy is really clear on what he's trying to do. That's exactly what I want from you. So once you've identified exactly what business you're in, the next question I'm going to ask you is, who is your ideal client? And when I say ideal client, almost everybody I know ends up essentially telling me everyone's their ideal client. Everybody. Because everybody wants to get everybody, right? So if I have a podcast, would I like to have more people listening to my podcast? Yes, of course I would. But will a random group of people be the best people to market to? No, because they're not going to find my podcast interesting. So what I want to do is I want to identify a group of people who are my ideal people to target for my podcast, because they're the people who are going to get the most from my podcast. And at the same time, they're the people that I want to speak to, right? That's critical for me. So for you, I ask you now, who is your ideal client? And I've developed a 3-step process to determining who your ideal client is. And it's very, very easy. So if you follow this 3-step approach, you're going to be able to identify exactly who your ideal client is. So you've got to work your way through 3 different things. Number 1, it's got to be a group where the business you do with them has to be high margin business. Meaning you don't want to build your business around an ideal client that's not high margin. And meaning that you've got to be able to make good profits on them, right? So it can't be the little stuff that you'll do, but you're not really making that much money. It's got to be high profit business. Number 2, there must be enough of them out there to make your business succeed. It's really important. You see, if you start a business and you have this ideal client where it's really high margin service or product, but you forget that there just isn't enough of that business out there, or there aren't enough of those people out there, well, then you're not going to be able to succeed. So 1, your business must be high margin that you do with them. Number 2, there must be enough of them out there for you to make your business succeed, right? And 3, it must be a product or service which you can provide at a very high quality. So what is a product or service that you can provide at a very high quality that is high margin, and it would be targeted towards enough people or enough businesses that can make your business thrive? You answer those 3 questions and come up with 1 set of ideal clients, and you now have your ideal client. Now, can you have 2 or 3 ideal clients? Yes, you can. You can have multiple ideal clients. You sort of order them, okay? And I really would not recommend going more than 2 or maybe 3 at the most, because you don't want to spread yourself too thin where you have 5 or 6 different ideal clients. So I would say pick 1, 2, or at most 3 ideal clients that are going to be the clients you target. So for my podcast, for example, we've identified 2 groups that are ideal groups, right? And we've identified them in more ways than you can possibly imagine. We have age groups, we have interests, we have all of that kind of stuff built into exactly who we want as the ideal client for this podcast. Not that this podcast won't speak to other people, but the ideal clients, the ones that we're willing to market to, the ones that we're going to talk to on a day-to-day basis, the ones who I'm going to think about before I start recording the podcast, those are the people who are the ideal clients. So for you, who is your ideal client? And again, the 3-step approach is simple. It's got to be high margin business, right? Number 2, there must be enough of them out there. And number 3, you must be able to provide that product or service at a very high quality. All right. So today, not only are you going to get down exactly what business you're in, but you're also going to identify exactly who your ideal client is. And finally, number 3, how do you make sure you don't get blockbustered? So let's review what happened to Blockbuster. You see, Blockbuster Video was this incredible business that was growing like crazy. In fact, they had these banners that they used to put up when they were opening up new stores. You remember them? They used to hang all over town, and it used to say, "Here we grow again." Can you imagine a company that was hanging up signs like that in the year 2000, bankrupt by 2014? It's amazing to think about that because they went from this great company. How did it happen? Here's how it happened. They forgot what broader business they were in. So the trick is this. If you don't understand what broad business you're in, this is, by the way, exactly the opposite of what I told you to do in step one. I told you to find out exactly what business you're in. But now I'm telling you, understand what broader business you're in. And they go hand in hand. Why? Because I want you to have laser focus. But at the same time, I want you to always remember the broader business that you're in. So let's look at Blockbuster. See, Blockbuster, they were really good at knowing exactly what business they were in. What business were they in? They were in the business of allowing families to go to a retail store and get videos very conveniently that they could rent, okay? That was the business they were in. They weren't trying to be the low price leader. They weren't. In fact, they were more expensive than most of the video stores, right? But they were convenient. They were everywhere. And when you went in, they always had the movies in stock. Whereas if you went to the local video shop, they used to have the things at a half price or a third of the price, but they weren't in stock oftentimes if they were one of the new movies. So Blockbuster became this convenient place. But here's where they screwed up. They forgot that the business they were in, although that was the ideal business for them, they were in a broader business of doing what? Allowing people to conveniently enjoy movies in the privacy of their home. See, if they had defined their business as what I just said, to conveniently allow people to enjoy movies in the privacy of their own home, see, that still would have differentiated them from a movie theater. But guess what? They wouldn't have lost out on the entire live streaming industry, and they wouldn't have gotten their butts handed to them when Netflix started mailing movies to people. See, Blockbuster had the opportunity to buy Netflix for literally pennies. I mean, for next to nothing, they could have bought Netflix, but they were never scared of them. Why? Because they said, that's not the industry we're in. We're not worried about Netflix. I mean, who's going to want to mail the movies to themselves? Well, guess what? A lot of people. And when streaming video came out, Blockbuster didn't think, we should be the leader in streaming video. Because what we do is we allow people to watch movies conveniently in the privacy of their own home. They were stuck on this retail model. And by the time they tried to turn around, by the way, at the end, they did try to turn around. And they came up with a feature where they mailed movies to you. And they tried the streaming thing and all this stuff. And it just didn't work because it was too late. Why? Because they didn't understand the broad business that they were in. So I ask you now. What broad business are you in so that if your little niche, something happens to it, something changes in the world or in your business, how are you going to be able to make sure that you still thrive? So ask yourself that question. Find out what broad business you're in. So here's your three things for the day, and we're going to say goodbye, and I'm going to be back here with you very soon with another episode. What you need to do, number one, find out what business you're in. Number two, who is your ideal client? And number three, what is the broad business that you're in so you don't end up like Blockbuster? Get those three figured out, and I want to help you grow massively in your business. In these next few episodes, I've got some incredible business tools I'm going to share with you, but remember, the number one most important asset of any business is you, the business owner and the entrepreneur. So we've got to make sure we keep you at tip-top shape. So I'm going to help you with fitness, with nutrition, with all sorts of things in your life because I want you to be at your best so your business can thrive. All right, get out there and remember, as always, the most important message I can leave you with is lead with your heart.